So next on our list of Christmas stuffings, I'm gonna do a traditional chestnut stuffing. Now this one's has got a few more ingredients than the sage and onion stuffing, but it tastes really, really nice. So if you have got the time, this one's well worth preparing. So for that, I have got 500 grams of sausage meat in there. I've got one onion and one clove of garlic, finely chopped. I have got 75 grams of dried cranberries. I don't know if you can see them so well. But basically, they've been soaked for the last hour in 50 milliliters of port. Now, you can't have Christmas without a bit of port. So the cranberries are soaking in that. That's about a quarter of a cup. Now, I'm using tin chestnuts for these. These have been peeled and cooked. So a great time saver there. And they taste really nice as well. I've also got three rashers of bacon, which I have just finely chopped up. And of course, I've got my breadcrumbs, which is about three slices of bread. And that's about 2.5 cups of breadcrumbs there, 140 grams. Now, what I'm gonna do first for this is I'm actually gonna gently fry the onions and bacon together first before I mix everything together. And that basically just makes it taste a bit nicer and slightly sweeter in the stuffing.
A bit of olive oil, and I'm just gonna pop in the onions. Bacon's going in. So just fry it till it's kind of starting to go brown.
Okay, so now that the onions and bacon have been fried for a couple of minutes, all you have to do is put everything all in one big bowl and mix it up, and that's it. So, I've got my onions and bacon, they're gonna go in. Okay. Now, to that, I'm going to add my cranberries and port, which have been soaking. That's all gonna go in. And I'm going to add my sausage meat. It's all gonna go in one big bowl. The breadcrumbs are going in. Smells really good actually. Okay, I'm also gonna add in 1 teaspoon of thyme. I've got some dried thyme here. Actually about a teaspoon and a half. Teaspoon and a half of thyme. I'm sorry, I always change my quantities when I'm doing this. Now for the chestnuts, I want them kind of like finely chopped really. So I'm just gonna put them in the blender, Magimix. Good old Magimix. That's 240 grams. That's probably a good cup and a half maybe of chestnuts there. Okay. Okay, that's fine. Now if you can't find whole chestnuts, it doesn't matter. You can use chestnut puree if you can find that. That will also taste lovely. So that's all gonna go in. Oh man, I love roast chestnuts at Christmas. Ooh, Christmas exciting. Right, so that's everything really. And a big pinch of salt and pepper. Season it well. So you don't need too much salt in this one because you've got the bacon, so that's kind of salty enough really. So just a little pinch of salt and then plenty of pepper. Now the last thing I'm gonna put in is one large egg, which basically the egg is just to hold it all together so that when you cut into it, it doesn't go all crumbly. Now, what we're gonna do now is just mix everything together. And I'm afraid you have to use your hands with this one because it just works a bit better that way. Okay, I shall bring. Right, so you just gotta get in there. Mix everything in, yeah. Okay, so once you've mixed everything together really well, all you have to do is roll it into balls, or you could use it to stuff the turkey, if that's what you want to do. So either way is fine. I'm gonna roll mine into balls and then just cook it on gas mark 5 for about, I'd say, probably 30 minutes. Depends how big your balls are. But I'm doing kind of little ones, so it won't take that long. So So yeah, between, I'd say, give it 30 minutes in the oven. Oh no, they're quite big actually. Wow. Right, make them smaller. Just pop it all on a baking tray and it goes in the oven. And it's as simple as that. So, big tip is to get all your stuffings and all your trimmings made the day before, even your bread sauce, your cranberry sauce, so that all you've got to do on Christmas is literally put the turkey in, put your veggies on, and you can chill and have a very relaxing, enjoyable Christmas day. And you can look for the recipe, the full recipe will be on my website.
Good, and have so a be very good, happy Christmas. For goodness sake.